Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the subject fluid mechanics and machines. And this is lecture number 12.4. We are going to discuss problem solving in centrifugal pump. In the earlier lecture also, we solved a few problems from the Anna University question paper. And in this lecture also, we take few more problems from the Anna University question paper in centrifugal pump. The learning outcome to the students, at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to solve problem in centrifugal pump. Example number 6 from November 2011 question paper. The following details refer to a centrifugal pump. The outer diameter is 30 cm, eye diameter is 15 cm. The blade angle at inlet 30 degree, blade angle at outlet 25 degree, speed 1440 rpm, the flow velocity remains constant. The wind velocity at inlet is 0, determine the work done per kg. If the manometric efficiency is 82%, determine working head. If the width at the outlet is 2 cm, determine power. You take overall efficiency as 76%. We write down the given data. Outer diameter D2 equal to 0.3 meter, eye diameter D1 equal to 0.15 meter, blade angle at the inlet theta equal to 30 degree, blade angle at the outlet phi equal to 25 degree, speed n equal to 1450 rpm, manometric efficiency 0.82, width at the outlet B2 equal to 0.02 meter, overall efficiency eta O equal to 0.76. We calculate the peripheral speed at the inlet and the outlet. U1 equal to pi D1 n divided by 60, substituting 3.14 into 0.15 into 1450 divided by 60 equal to 11.38 meters per second. U2 equal to pi D2 n divided by 60 equal to 3.14 into 0.3 into 1450 divided by 60 equal to 22.76 meters per second. And this is the inlet velocity triangle for the centrifugal pump. U1 is the peripheral speed, Vf1 is the flow velocity, and theta is the angle of the blade at the inlet. From the velocity triangle, we calculate the flow velocity Vf1 equal to U1 tan theta, which is 7.38 into 1030 equal to 6.57 meters per second. And looking at the outlet velocity triangle, U2 is the peripheral speed at the outlet, Vw2 is the tangential velocity, Vf2 is the flow velocity, phi is the blade angle at the outlet. Wind velocity at the outlet Vw2 from the velocity triangle Vw2 equal to U2 minus Vf2 by tan phi, which is 22.76 minus 6.57 divided by tan 25 equal to 8.67 meters per second. And the work done W equal to U2 Vw2 peripheral speed at the outlet into the wind velocity 22.76 into 8.67 equal to 197.3 joules. And the head of the pump, from the definition of manometric efficiency, manometric head equal to U2 Vw2 manometric efficiency divided by G. Substituting numerical values 22.76 into 8.67 into 0.82 divided by 9.81 equal to 16.49 meter. And discharge Q equal to area at the outlet pi D2B2 into flow velocity Vf2. So, this is 3.14 into 0.3 into 0.02 into 6.57 equal to 0.124 meter cube per second. And the power input to the pump, P equal to rho GQHM divided by overall efficiency. So, 1000 into 9.81 into 0.124 into 16.79 divided by 0.76 equal to 26.4 kilowatts. The answer to the problem, work done per kg of water, 197.3 joules. Head of the pump 16.49 meter and power required is 26.4 kilowatts. The next example, example number 7 from November 2019 question paper. A centrifugal pump has an impeller internal diameter 0.12 meter, external diameter 0.24 meter, which rotates at 1200 rpm. The absolute velocity of water at the inlet is radial, vanes are curved back at an angle of 25 degree to the tangent at the outlet. The width of the impeller at the inlet and the outlet are 0.016 meter and 0.008 meter respectively. Determine the gain of pressure head as water passes through the impeller, neglecting the losses. The pump discharges water at a rate of 500 liters per minute. So, write down the given data. Internal diameter D1 equal to 0.12 meter, external diameter D2 equal to 0.24 meter, speed N equal to 1200 RPM, outlet blade angle phi equal to 25 degree, width at the inlet B1 equal to 0.016 meter, width at the outlet B2 equal to 0.008 meter, and discharge equal to 500 liters per minute, which is 0.5 meter cube per minute. And we calculate the peripheral speed at the inlet and the outlet, U1 equal to pi D1 N divided by 60, so 3.14 into 0.12 into 1200 divided by 60 equal to 7.536 meters per second, and U2 equal to pi D2 N divided by 60, which is 3.14 into 0.24 into 1200 divided by 60 equal to 15.07 meters per second. And flow velocity at the outlet, from the definition of discharge, flow velocity at the outlet VFD equal to Q discharge divided by the area pi G2 B2, so 0.5 divided by 60 into 3.14 into 0.12 into 0.008 equal to 2.76 meters per second. Then the flow velocity is constant, so VF1 equal to VF2 equal to V1 equal to 2.76 meters per second. So, this is the outlet velocity triangle, U2 is the peripheral speed at the outlet, VWT is the tangent velocity, VF2 is the flow velocity, and phi is the blade angle at the outlet. So, the whirl velocity at the outlet, VWT equal to U2 minus VF2 by tan phi, 15.07 minus 2.76 divided by tan 25 equal to 9.15 meters per second. The absolute velocity at the outlet, from the velocity triangle, V2, this is the length is absolute velocity, V2 equal to square root of VF2 square plus VW2 square, which is 2.76 square plus 9.15 square equal to 9.56 meters per second. The theoretical head developed by the pump, so theoretical head is equal to U2 VW2 divided by G, so 15.07 into 9.15 divided by 9.81 equal to 14 meter. Then pressurize across the impeller, so the Bernoulli's equation for the impeller, pressure head VP1 by W, velocity head V1 square by 2G, datum head Z1, and theoretical head H theoretical equal to pressure head at the outlet P2 by W, specific weight plus V2 square by 2G, velocity head plus datum head. Assuming Z1 equal to Z2, so this is the remaining terms P1 by W plus V1 square by 2G plus H theoretical equal to P2 by W plus V2 square by 2G. So rearranging the terms, P2 by W minus P1 by W equal to V1 square by 2G minus V2 square by 2G plus H theoretical. The numerator P2 minus P1 is the pressurized across the impeller divided by specific weight equal to 9810 for the water. So V1 square 2.76 square divided by 2 into 9.81 minus V2 9.56 square divided by 2 into 9.81 plus theoretical head equal to 14. So right hand side value is 9.73. So, the pressure is across the impeller 9.73 into 9810 equal to 95,451.3 newtons per meter square. So, the gain in pressure head across the impeller equal to 9.73 meter or 95,451.3 newtons per meter square. So, the answer to the problem. The next example, example number 8 from November 2009 question paper. A centrifugal pump having outer diameter equal to 2 times the inner diameter and running at 1000 rpm works against the head of 40 meter. The velocity of the flow through the impeller is constant and equal to 2.5 meters per second. The vanes are set back at an angle of 40 degree at the outlet. If the outer diameter of the impeller is 500 mm and the width at the outlet is 50 mm, determine van angle at the inlet, manometric efficiency, work done by the impeller on water per second. So, write down the given data, D2 equal to 2 times of D1, speed N equal to 1000 rpm, head equal to 40 meter, flow velocity is constant at 2.5 meters per second, van angle at the outlet phi equal to 40 degree, outer diameter is D2 equal to 0.5 meter, outer width equal to 0.05 meter, B2 equal to 0.05 meter, inner diameter D1 equal to 0.25 meter. So, D1 equal to D2 divided by 2. So, the peripheral speed at the inlet and the outlet, so U1 equal to pi D1 N divided by 60, so 3.14 into 0.25 into 1000 divided by 60 equal to 13.08 meters per second, and U2 equal to pi D2 N divided by 60, so 3.14 into 0.5 into 1000 divided by 60 equal to 26.16 meters per second. So, referring to the inlet velocity triangle, so theta is the inlet blade angle, VF1 is the flow velocity, U1 is the peripheral speed at the inlet, theta equal to tan inverse of V of 1 by U1 equal to tan inverse of 2.5 divided by 13.08 equal to 10.8 degrees. And this is the outlet velocity triangle. So, referring to the outlet velocity triangle VW2, whirl velocity at the outlet VW2 equal to U2 minus VF2 by tan phi. So, 26.16 minus 2.5 divided by tan 40 equal to 23.18 meters per second. And the manometric efficiency from the definition GHM divided by U2 VW2. So, 9.81 into 40 divided by 26.16 into 23.18 equal to 0.647, which is 64.7%. And discharge from the pump Q equal to pi D2B2. This is the area for the flow at the outlet into VF2. So, 3.14 into 0.5 into 0.05 into 2.5 equal to 0.196 meter cube per second. Then work done. Work done W equal to mass flow rate. Mass flow is rho into Q. So, density of water into discharge equal to mass flow rate into U2 VW2. 1000 into 0.196 into 26.16 into 23.18 equal to 118.8 into 10 power 3 watts. So, the answer to the problem, van angle at the inlet 10.8 degree, manometric efficiency 64.7%, work done by the impeller and water per second 118.8 kilowatts. Example number 9 from May 2019 question paper. A centrifugal pump lifts water against a static head of 32.061 meter, of which 3.054 meter is suction lift. Both the suction and delivery pipes are 12.7 centimeter in diameter. The loss of heat in the suction pipe is 1.07 meter of water and in delivery pipe is 5.955 meter of water. The impeller is 30.54 centimeter in diameter and 2.54 centimeter wide at the outlet. It revolves at 1450 rpm and the blade angle at the exit is 35 degree. The manometric efficiency of the pump is 80% and the overall efficiency is 68%. Determine the discharge of the pump, the power required to drive the pump and the pressure at the two branches of the pipe. Neglect the effect of van thickness of the area of the flow. So, we write down the given data, head equal to 32.061 meter. Suction head HS equal to 3.054 meter, diameter of the delivery pipe 0.127 meter, loss of heat in the suction HFS equal to 1.07 meter, loss of heat in the delivery HFD equal to 5.955 meter, diameter of the impeller at the outlet D2 equal to 0.3054 meter, width of the impeller at the outlet B2 equal to 0.0254 meter, speed 1440 rpm, blade angle at the outlet phi equal to 35 degree. Manometric efficiency 80% 0.8, overall efficiency 68% 0.68. We calculate the discharge of the pump. Discharge Q equal to pi by 4 dp square. So, area and velocity in the delivery pipe. Cross section area of the delivery pipe into velocity in the delivery pipe 3.14 divided by 4 into 0.127 square into Vd, which is 0.01266 Vd. Vd is the velocity of the water in the delivery pipe. This discharge is also is given as the area at the discharge area at the outlet of the centrifugal pump into VF2. So, 3.14 into 0.3054 into 0.0254 into VF2 is equal to 0.0243 VF2. So, these two equations are equal. So, 0.01266 VD equal to 0.0243 VF2. So, VF2 equal to 0.52 times of VD. So, VF2 is the flow velocity at the outlet, VD is the velocity of the water in the delivery pipe. So, the peripheral speed at the outlet, U2 equal to pi D2N divided by 60. So, 3.14 into 0.3054 into 1450 divided by 60 equal to 23.17 meters per second. And referring to the outlet velocity triangle of the centrifugal pump, we calculate the whirl velocity. So, whirl velocity VW2 equal to U2 minus VF2 by tan phi. Is 23.17 minus VF2 divided by tan 35 equal to 23.17 minus 1.428 into VF2. So, VF2 is also unknown. VW2 is also unknown. Now, we take the manometric head. Manometric head, the formula is HM equal to HS, suction head, delivery head HD, HFS, head loss due to friction in the suction pipeline, HFD, head loss in the delivery side, and the VD square by 2G. So HS is given as 32.067. HS plus HD is called as static head, which is 32.067. HF is equal to 1.07. HFD equal to 5.955 into VD square by 2 into 9.81. So adding, simplifying, 39.092 into point plus 0.0551 into VD square. This is the HM, manometric head. And this manometric head, from the definition of manometric efficiency, manometric head equal to VW2 U2 divided by G into manometric efficiency. So VW2 already we have calculated U2 minus 1.428 VF2 into U2 divided by G into manometric efficiency. So HM equal to U2 equal to 23.17 minus 1.428 VF2 into 23.17 divided by 9.81 into 0.8. So simplifying, 1.9 into 23.17 minus 1.428 VF2. So further calculating, so taking 1.9, multiplying 1.9 inside the bracket, HM equal to 44.023 minus 2.71 VF2. Now you substitute for VF2, VF2 equal to 0.51 VD, already we have calculated. So 44.023 minus 2.71 into 0.51 VD. So simplifying, 44.023 minus 1.409 VD, HM equal to 44.023 minus 1.409 VD. Now we have two equations for manometric head. HM equal to 39.092 plus 0.051 VD square, and we have another term here, 44.023 minus 1.409 VD, and these two equations are equal. 44.023 minus 1.409 VD equal to 39.092 plus 0.051 VD square. So rearranging the term, we'll get a quadratic equation. So 0.051 VD square plus 1.409 VD minus 4.991 equal to 0. So solving the equation, VD equal to minus B plus or minus square root of B square minus 4AC divided by 2A. So using the equation, VD equal to minus of 1.409 plus or minus the value within the square bracket 1.733 divided by 1.102. So we take the, calculate the value, which is 3.2 meters per second. So VD velocity in the discharge pipeline equal to 3.2 meters per second, and velocity of the flow VF2 equal to 0.52 times of VD, 0.52 into 3.2 equal to 1.664 meters per second. Then discharge equal to, already we derived discharge equal to 0.0243 VF2, which is 0.0243 into 1.664 equal to 0.04 meter cube per second, and manometric head equal to HM equal to 44.023 minus 1.409 VD, which is 44.023 minus 1.409 into 3.2 equal to 39.51 meter. And power required to drive the pump. So P equal to rho G Q HM divided by overall efficiency. So 1000 into 9.81 into 0.04 into 39.51 divided by 0.68 equal to 22,799.6 watts or 22.8 kilowatts. The pressure and the delivery pipe. So PD by rho G equal to HD plus HFD plus VD square by 2G. So HD is the head in the delivery side, so which is static head minus suction head. So total head is H, suction head is you have to subtract, so to calculate the delivery head, plus HFD plus VD square by 2G. So PD by rho G equal to 32.07 minus 3.054 plus 5.955 plus 3.2 square divided by 2 into 9.81 equal to 35.49. And the PD equal to 35.49 into rho G, which is 35.49 9810 equal to 3.48 10 power 5 newtons per meter square. The pressure head, pressure in the suction pipeline, PS by rho G equal to PD by rho G minus HM. So 35.49 minus 39.5 equal to minus 4.01 meter. So PS equal to minus 4.01 into rho G equal to minus 4.01 9810 equal to minus of 0.39 10 power 5 newtons per meter square. The answer to the problem, discharge of the pump 0.04 meter cube per second, power required to drive the pump 22.4 kilowatt, pressure at the two branches of the pipe. So PD equal to 3.48 10 power 5 newtons per meter square, and PS equal to minus of 0.39 10 power 5 newtons per meter square. Example number 10 from May 2019 question paper. The internal and external diameter of impeller of a centrifugal pump which is running at 1200 rpm are 200 millimeter and 400 millimeter. The discharge of the discharge through the pump is 0.05 meter cube per second. The velocity of the flow is constant and equal to 2.5 meters per second. Diameter of the suction and the delivery pipes are 150 and 100 millimeter respectively. The suction and the delivery heads are 6 meter absolute and 30 meter absolute of water. If the outlet van angle is 45 degree, power required to drive the pump is 19 kilowatts. Determine van angle of the impeller at the inlet, overall efficiency of the pump and manometric efficiency of the pump. So, we write down the given data. Speed 1200 rpm, inner diameter d1 equal to 0.2 meter, outer diameter d2 equal to 0.4 meter, discharge q equal to 0.05 meter cube per second, flow velocity vf equal to 2.5 meters per second, suction pipe diameter ds equal to 0.15 meter, delivery pipe diameter dd equal to 0.1 meter, suction head 6 meter, delivery head 30 meter, van angle at the outlet is phi equal to 45 degree, power is 19 kilowatts. We calculate the peripheral speed at the inlet and the outlet, u1 equal to pi d1n divided by 60, which is 3.14 into 0.2 into 1200 divided by 60 equal to 12.56 meters per second, u2 equal to pi d2n divided by 60, which is 3.14 into 0.4 into 1200 divided by 60 equal to 25.12 meters per second. So, referring to the inlet velocity triangle of the centrifugal pump, so theta is the blade angle at the inlet, u1 is the peripheral speed, vf1 is the flow velocity. The blade angle at the inlet, theta equal to tan inverse of vf1 by u1, which is tan inverse of 2.5 divided by 12.56 equal to 5.68 degree. Referring to the outlet velocity triangle of the centrifugal pump, the whirl velocity at the outlet, vw2 equal to u2 minus vf2 by tan 5, which is 25.12 minus 2.5 divided by tan 45 equal to 22.62 meters per second. The velocity of water in the delivery pipe, Vd equal to Q by Ad, area of the delivery pipe, Q by pi by 4 Dd square equal to 0.05 divided by pi by 4 into 0.1 square equal to 6.37 meters per second. Velocity of the water in the suction pipe, Vs equal to Q divided by As, area of the suction pipe, so Q by pi by 4 Ds square, which is 0.05 divided by pi by 4 into 0.15 square equal to 2.83 meters per second. So, the manometric head, Hm equal to head and the delivery side, Hd plus Vd square by 2g minus head at the suction side, Hs plus Vs square by 2g. So, 30 plus 6.37 square divided by 2 into 9.81 minus 6 plus 2.83 square divided by 2 into 9.81 equal to 25.66 meter. Overall efficiency of the pump, so the power, the hydraulic power, rho g q hm divided by the power. So, this is equal to 1000 into 9.81 into 0.05 into 25.66 divided by 19,000 is equal to 0.662, which is 66.2%. And manometric efficiency, from the definition, manometric efficiency equal to g hm divided by u2 vw2 9.81 into 25.66 divided by 25.12 into 22.62 equal to 0.443 equal to 44.3%. The answer to the problem, van angle of the impeller at the inlet 5.68 degree, overall efficiency of the pump 66.2%, manometric efficiency of the pump 44.3%. So, we stop here. So, these are all the books I published in mechanical engineering. So, you may find the fluid mechanics and machinery. And if you want additional problems on the theory, you can refer to the book. And I upload the video lectures of all the subjects mentioned here in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel, use the videos for your better learning. So, thank you for watching. Please post your comments in the comments box. You can contact me for any clarification through my mail ID or WhatsApp number. Thank you. We'll meet again with another video in fluid mechanics.